retail when you began was more traditional retail in this country. I think we must be the country with the maximum number of traditional retail businesses, and you got into modern business.
Yeah, India is probably a nation of shopkeepers. If you look at it, we have close to about 10 million retailers. So 1 crore retailer for 120 crore population. So you have almost one retailer for every 120 beings in India. I don't think we can get any better than this. So we are a nation of shopkeepers. And when I came into Mumbai didn't have the so-called modern retail, but they were very good retailers. I mean, Amarsons, Premsons, Akbar Ali's. I mean, they were all very, very intelligent retailers, Nullies in the south. But this was also unique from one point of view that I was an employee of the company. So probably only retailer in the world which has been started by an employee for a family. Otherwise, all retailers start with the family and then give it to an employee. So a unique proposition. Interesting, you mentioned Gorakhpur. Yeah. And actually, before I came to Mumbai, I could speak Bhojpuri very well. Mumbai has actually taken away my Bhojpuri, but I also, when I started speaking Bhojpuri, people started calling me Bhaiya. So I said, let me not get into that part of mine. And well, Gorakhpur is a phenomenal place. We used to have, my classmates used to come on horses into the classroom, right up. The horse used to be parked outside the classroom. So
without number plates.
Without number plates. Without number plates, you know. It's an amazing journey from Gorakhpur.
How was the transition from your 128 stores across the country to one location to begin with? What experience did you carry forward from your past 10 years of three organizations to Shoppers Stop in 1991?
See, Rajesh, this was totally different for me. I mean, running a 500 square feet to dreaming to run a 50,000 square feet was very different. So what did I have or what did I bring on the table was, I was always a very employee and customer-centric person. So whether I did in my college, my projects, or did in Corona, for me, everything in an organization is either customer-centric or employee. No. It is customer-centric and employee-oriented. And actually, that has been the biggest help for me. Retail is nothing. It's all about people. So you learn from people and do for people.
How did you take on the Benzers and the Amersons and the Akbaralis of those times?
It was not very difficult. You know, for South Mumbai people, coming to Andheri is going to London. So they didn't want to come and I didn't want to get them. So it was as easy as that, you know. So honestly, Andheri Shoppers Stop was serving its catchment. And even today, we started with one. Today we have 11, 12, we can open three more stores. It's such a catchment business. And Mumbai is such a dense population. I mean, you can do any amount of business as long as you know how to serve your customers. So that's not a problem.
Once you made it big, how did you get into finance management? Because it was revenues coming in against the growth that you wanted. How did you balance that?
Well, one thing I must give hats off to the Raheja family. From day one, they didn't give me equity. Every money you had an interest to it. So there was nothing called a free money. And I think that's something that all of us should learn. So you're made accountable for the money.
So the interest kept you interested?
Well, interest kept me disinterested from them because it was cheaper to borrow from the bank than to get from them. I hope this is not, this is getting telecast also. So, okay. But now I'm a board member, vice chairman, so I can manage it now. Yeah, no, it was, so we always, one thing that I must say is, I always say that in an Indian market, you have to build capability before you build capacity. Most of the organizations who have failed are the ones who build capacity and then try to build capability, it doesn't happen. So if you look at this, from 91 to 98, we had only two stores. We opened the third store in 98. And then we started building. So we were called the slow turtle of retail because we were slow. But today, we are one of the few standing up and have been a profitable retailer through and through. So to me, it's important to build capability and then build capacity. So you are never overspending. So for us, if you look at our balance sheets for the last 20 years, our debt equity ratio has been 1:1. Okay, and if you look at many retailers who stretch to 1:2, 1:3, 1:4, I think that's not the principle that we have worked on. And still we have grown at a CAGR of maybe 18, 19, 20% for 25 years.
Wow, and that is consistent. Well, how was your feedback management system? The customers give the feedback to the sales team gives the feedback to the management. How do you use that customer feedback system with your vendors?
Okay, I think one of the important thing is that retail is a business where decisions have to be taken at the point of contact. So when it is vendors, it is our merchandisers. When it is customers, it is our front end. So very early, we actually said that what is the empowerment required for vendors and our merchandisers to deal and our store managers and the customers to deal. Anything to do with customers stops at the store manager. The store manager need not come to a head office at all for any decision. I can give you examples, hundreds of them, where a store manager will take a call, give away a 10,000 gift voucher because he made a mistake. Okay, same thing goes with vendors. And there were some basic principles also that we fitted up. So for example, one of the values that we had in the company was, we will not take what is not ours. So no employee in the company, anybody right up to the top takes a gift. Because we don't do that, so therefore this whole corruption that is there in the whole buying and selling system was absolutely eroded. In fact, there was a vendor who called me saying, aapke ek nahi buyer join ki hai, and she's asking for money. Maine usko bola ki agar main bol dunga to naukri chala jayega. So I said, wahin se bhej do usko, you have authorized to sack her. So he sacked a buyer of mine who was my employee because she was doing something which was wrong. So again, I'm saying it's all an approach of how do you work partner? Because the common cause is customer and not common cause is business. Business automatically happens.
What was the methodology that you adapted to make sure your thoughts percolate to the last man in the organization? And how did you build the ethics system in the organization?
So one is, I think, retail is a very transparent business. When you walk the floor, it's visible to everybody. Because you can't do something from the cabin. Dukandari peeche se nahi chalta, dukandari aage baith ke chalta hai. So everybody watches you. So you have to walk the talk. I think that's number one. Number two is this when we did this customer care associate, it actually equalized the whole organization in a big way. Because I may be the managing director as a function, but I am the same designation as you. That's the second thing that happened. The third is that every day morning would start with a town hall meeting, every day. The first 9 years, every employee in the shop was interviewed by me personally. Because my belief is, if culturally you have the right team, then nothing can go wrong. And culture building and value creation is probably the largest input that the managing director or the CEO has to build in the organization. Every human being comes to work wanting to perform. We believe that they don't want to perform. It's not true. You have a great culture, the organization works. Even today, at 10:45, across the company, 18,000 people sing the anthem of Shop to Stop across the company from head office to the town. So we meet. We are like a family meeting. It's like family having dinner together. We have anthem together.
Well, it's basically a very employee-engaged business model. So how did you avoid being poached, your people being poached, and how did you poach?
Well, the first is that for the first 4 years of the business, we did not take a single employee from either textile, garment, or fashion background, not one person. Because the moment you take a person from anywhere, he says, ye nahi ho sakta hai, because it comes with a baggage. We wanted people who could say, ki sab kuch ho sakta hai. And that, I think, really, really helped us. We always have developed people from below. If you look at Shoppers, there's a very good case study called the kangaroo system of training. So you will take people right from the bottom. So our sales associates have become store managers, general managers. 75% of the hierarchy is built within the company. And we had graduate trainees, management trainees. I mean, today, if you look at the management, I think the top three people have been in the business for the last 14 years, 20 years. Apna company kaun chhod ke jata? Aap apna ghar chhod ke jate ho kya? It just doesn't happen.
But we leave the home to go to a better home all the time.
Well, then he's actually carrying your brand. So let me tell you a story. One of my guys left Shoppers after 10 years and he joined the other company. And he was asked to give an inauguration speech. He said, welcome to Shoppers Stop. Because he totally forgot that he's joined a new company. He's so used to the brand. So when people leave and go somewhere, there are brand ambassadors there. And you know, people say, oh, you're doing a good job. Where did you learn? I learned in Shoppers Stop. So actually, if you encourage, they become a brand ambassadors. And sometimes such growth is good for the organization because you require fresh people to come in.
In 2008, 2010, that patch, the whole world went through the turmoil of downturns. And everybody learned lessons which helped them either to exist or perish. What were your learnings in that downtimes?
I think two learnings. One learning is, in a market like India, where you're dealing with Indian customers with Indian revenues, but we almost have reached European costs. I think you have to learn the way Europeans in the Western world works. With 1% growth, they are still able to sow 10% profits. I think in India, what's happened is with 10% growth, we actually escalate our cost by 12 to 15%. So somewhere at the board level, we said, can we really work out every time, every year thinking there's a downturn? So every year when you're saying 12% growth, you say, okay, no. Work out your cost on the basis of 8% growth, but look at the revenue as a 12% growth. It actually helps you. Second is, retail is a penny business. Chahe aap $1 billion karo ya $10 billion karo, ginna ek rupaya padta hai. So if you are a penny business, you have to learn to work like a penny. And I think that's very, very critical.
How did you plan e-commerce to be the strength of a retail store, retail organization? Because e-commerce, when it came, it was a threat to all organizations. They started feeling that now every human being in this country is going to buy online. So how did you take that system when it came up? Last 7-8 years, I think e-commerce has been spoken about a lot. So how did you make it your strength rather than your weakness?
Actually, not many people know that we were actually the first brick and mortar guys to start online as early as 1998. Okay, but we didn't have the guts, because when we went and presented to the board and said, we have a business where we can do a 1 crore, but it's going to burn 10 crores. I mean, we all became nervous. Yeah. So we started and we closed. And now it's been a late entry. But if you go around the world, the biggest and the most profitable businesses in retail are the omni-channel business, whether it is Saks, whether it is John Lewis in UK. So India also, you'll find a lot of omni-channel players who are doing online and offline both. I think Shoppers in the next 12 to 18 months will be an omni-channel player. And you'll actually see them serving the customers 24/7 through online and offline. And as far as the competition is concerned, it is very, very welcome. Because actually it has put the whole offline players on the toes. Because nobody ever thought that the online is going to hit so much. And I think we are getting prepared for it.
What has competition taught you?
Competition has taught you to keep your eyes open 24/7. Because we have to watch. Competition has also taught us, and we have learned a lesson, that every time you can't be just thinking about competition, because many times you think of competition and forget about looking at your own business. And that's actually happening. Second is that customer never gives it all. And no retailer can take it all. So every time you feel that wo customer chala gaya hai, jaise wo aapka customer uske paas chala gaya hai, same other customer can come. So I'm saying in retail business, service business, by all business, if you have a very strong customer centricity, chances of losing the customer becomes less. And how do you transfer the customer centricity from the top man to the bottom, or from the bottom to the top?
What are the next steps that you did once you expanded from Bombay? How did you do your market survey before venturing into a new virgin market?
That was not very difficult, because two things happened. One is, you know that the cities have been growing. The top 5 metro cities were the first available. We had the first mover, so we got better properties. The second is, although we were selling out of only Shoppers Stop in Andheri, but we started getting a lot of customers from all over the country. And since we had a First Citizens Club, we almost knew that if we go to Hyderabad, you already have 10,000 First Citizens. Okay, so we would actually talk to them. So we had the advantage of talking to our prospective customers even before entering the place. And after that, it was all about looking at analytics, looking at the catchment, and doing those things. But we do have made mistakes, because location is the key. So I would say we hit probably 8 on 10 or 9 on 10 in terms of good location, but we've had failures.
From the retail space, I think you made it like a movement. Like, you started the trust for the retail organizations. You brought almost 21 countries together. You created award platforms. What was the reason behind that, and how successful have you been in that?
I don't know. I think my dad influenced in this journey of mine, and I took a call when I was 45 that at the age of 50, I'll step out. And I said, this is 25 years of learning, 25 years of earning, and 25 years of returning. So when I turned 50, I said, it's all going to be my returning phase. But I think the bigger learning for me is, because I had taken that call, and I knew that the Rahejas are not going to run Shoppers Stop. They're very involved, but they don't run directly. At the age of 45, when I took this call, I did tell the board that allow me to help with succession. And to me, I think that is extremely important. I mean, this is a message I definitely would want to pass to the audience, is that every day, or at least every week, I mean, whatever suits you, think that you're going to die tomorrow. And think, what is it that, what will happen to the organization? What can you do? So one is, you'll enjoy today very well. Because if you know that tomorrow is last day, then you'll enjoy today. Yeah. The second thing is that then you know that you have created a succession which can run larger than you and longer than you. So to me, let go is a very important part of the business. And that helped me in actually building this. Because this was my journey towards giving back, therefore I started this trust, wanting to see if employees who work in retail, there are 3.5 crores, 35 million people who work in retail. So my trust actually works for that. In 4.5 years, we've reached global. Last year, we had about 40 lakh people who celebrated Retail Employees Day in India and Turkey. And of course, we have 25 centers for disabled youth that we run. This year, we'll have 1,600 disabled youth who will get livelihood in the retail business. We train employees at $1 a class. This year, we would have ended up training 5,500 employees.
When we give the mug, we take a promise. All liquids should be used in this cup only.
Define all liquids.